What's up? YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, JordanDepot.com, SneakerTube.tv, BoxHeadShirts.com, SneakerShoebox.com, BarbershopSports.com, Black Santa 24, Franulations, JStar 25, Mel Dubs, E-Money, Monica 1984 Jersey, Black Korean Goddess 22. It is Tuesday, February the 1st, 2011. Earlier, I did my question and answer session and my JCOTD. I'm going to do a second JCOTD with these shoes because I know people will be wondering, what in the world can you wear with shoe number 281? So I had that on now, and we'll do that. First of all, I want to say Logan J. Bays is the winner with the 2008 Countdown Pack Carmine Sixes in JSB 7. So congratulations to Logan J. Bays on winning that. We have JSB 8 coming up. I'm going to do my shout out 5, then I'm going to give you the 16 participants. I want to go D-Rock 406, Dex 404, JZ 23650. Again, thank you for the J Rich throwback Golden State Warriors jersey. Trey Wimberly and the John Blank. The 16 participants of the final JSB number 8 before we hit the ultimate JSB 9, which will represent the winners of JSBs 1 through 8. All right, the lineup for JSB 8 is Led Zeppelin 8, 90, N90 Master, J-Rod, Ms. Attitude, Dubstep Slap 415, Carbon Fiber Cantana, Cheap, R Kicks, R.I., Louisville 7709, Thunderlax 07, Machiavelli 2152, Dark Rebel aka JRA, Nadtar from over in the UK, Brady 001, Space Ace X 1, Lips Manilex, and Treasy Breezy. Those are the 16. You know, Kalen and Khalil will be back on tomorrow to pick the brackets and set up the battle, which will kick off on Thursday. So stay tuned for that. Let's jump off into this JCOTD. I got a new alignment. I got all of the shoes 1 through 23 on the back wall here, and I got it pretty much set the way I like it now. Let's jump off into this shoe number 281, which is the Jordan Select Low 315-308, colorway 171. This is it right here. With your tumbled leather, you have your elephant print here along the toe, your perforations here with the holes, which I thought were pretty unique. Your elephant print in the back with your yellow Jumpman. And then the laces are white. And you have your silver Jumpman there on the tongue. And you can also here, it's a little go-go gadget button here, where you can push this button and tighten or loosen your laces. Pretty sweet. I got to set this down to show you the insoles of these shoes are like none I've seen before. You can take the insole out. Now, why couldn't they do all the insoles nice and thick like this? It also has, I don't know if you can see it, Jordan engraved in here. And this is actual stitching. If you touch it, anybody had these shoes, please shout it out and let me know if you have them. This is the bottom of them. This is a casual shoe. I wear them with shorts. I have a Dickie outfit for them too, a short outfit and a pant outfit to wear with these. I get a lot of compliments on these shoes. Also, there is a gray pair that is suede here on the inside, and you have your tumbled leather and your leathers with the hole for perforations here on the outside, and you have leather around the toe box area. Once again, we have these Buckeye colors, and it has the same insole here, nice and thick, with Jordan written across it. I don't know if you can see it. Let me know if you can. But these are some of my casual shoes that I wear with my casual wear. So this is shoe number 316, which you will see later down the road. Let's go into the straight to the foot game with these. Might not be able to show you the shoes. Running up on 6 minutes. Real casual, comfortable shoe. A lot of people thought they were bowling shoes because of the way that they fit. And I'll show you, take the gray ones straight to the foot gang. Out of the two, I like the first ones I wore better, but I like this mixture of the suede and the leather on these. All right, this is the ones. I showed this before, but I just moved the ones up. These are the ones. Still in the ones. I love the ones, so I'm deep in the ones. If you can count them, you're a bad person. And I'm deep in the ones. Mel Dubs, she really loves the ones, and talked to her a lot on Twitter. Real nice woman on there. Okay, now we're rolling into the twos right here, the low twos, those three there from 2005. Then back up top, this is my very first shoe, the 1994 retro too low. Then we jump to the threes right here. There's that cement boy in the box. Already got the picture on deck. The fours. Then the fives. Sixes, and we scoop down to the sevens. Then my all-time faves, the eights, and then the nines, then the tens. And the 11s. There's the UK boy. Still got to put a picture on that one. The 12s. 13s. There's the Benz. 14s. Continue down low. couple more 13s, then 14s. Then the 15s. Have a 20 mixed in there. Here's the 16s, the three that I have are the 16s with the shrouds. 17s. All three of these are DS, and I picked up an extra one in black, and I have a white coming in that is NDS, so I can wear the black and the white. That's NDS. That's near dead stock for people that aren't sure what that is. The 18, the 18.5s, the 19s, another 18.5 that my little big brother KMOB traded with me. I needed that one. I had the white one. And I needed this, the black one, which is a shoe that Carmelo wore. The 20s. This is a new one that I traded with a guy on Facebook and Twitter. I traded the Black Cat 3 for this one. Here's the 20 low. The 21s. 22s. Here's the 23s. I'm deep with the 23s also. The 2009 up here. And the 2010 will end it. And this is a look. At the basement at Jay. I'm going to end with saying I appreciate everyone for taking the time to view the vid today, the question and answer vid. I felt I needed to let people know who noticed that there was a change in me, what the situation is. I'm still waiting on authorization to have this further exam of my back that they want to do to relieve the pain and try injections or whatever they want to try, but I'm not really wanting surgery, but that is my very last option. After, if you saw my knee, what that turned out to be like, I'm just not that trustworthy of any surgeries. I stated that not for any sympathy or anything. I just wanted to let people know you in life, when you make decisions, the outcome might not be what you think is going to be. I never thought that it would end up like this. I never thought that I'd have limitations. I never thought that I'd have to learn how to walk again after spending 3 months in the hospital. All of that took place. I'm just thankful that I still have my leg. Although my knee is prosthetic, I still have my leg, and I can still get around with my kids. Not like I want to, but it's better than not having one. All right. It's your boy Jumpman. I'm fading to the back. From the basement of the Jays. I appreciate everyone, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, for the messages, hitting me up, the comments. I still have some comments to catch up to. I took a nap with my kids, took a nap. You know, it's a full-time job being a stay-at-home dad, so I commend all mothers who do this on a daily basis. My big hug to you all, because it is not easy. And for the guys that do it, besides me, I'm sure there's other guys that do it. Saying to you, pound up to you. All right, I'll holler at you later. Peace.